Good morning. Good morning. How are you guys? I'm gonna wait and see if anybody jumps on. It is oh dark 30 here on Sanibel, and it is almost sunrise. We are getting there. If you are jumping on with me, good morning. Comment below, let me know you're here. If you have never joined me for an online virtual beach exploration, you're really in for a treat because it's really, really fun. So if you are landlocked and you want a little taste of the beach this morning, you will get it. I am live this morning on Sanibel for sunrise. We are down on the east end near Lighthouse Point. We walked down a little ways, and I'm going to go ahead and just do a little beach walk and a little beach combing. The last time I did this live was back on Thanksgiving. Good morning, guys. And it was really fun for you guys. So I'm on the edge of an island. So if my signal gets a little sketchy, please let me know, because it will always look okay from my perspective. So please comment, good morning, Boyd, how are you? Good morning, and let me know. And I'm gonna periodically shoot you towards the sunrise so you guys can see it, because it's absolutely spectacular here. Every once in a while, you guys will see me post sunrise pictures, but you think they're sunset photos, and they're not. They're sunrise photos. So you'll know why Sanibel sunrises rival sunsets. So here we go. I gotta use a flashlight because it is really dark here on the beach still. But as it gets lighter, I'll be able to turn that off and you'll be able to see a little bit better. Hi, Mari, good morning. So I'm gonna flip you guys around. And here we go. So this is the start of sunrise, you guys. It's absolutely beautiful. And down here, you can see the lighthouse. So there's the light shining brightly. And here is the beginning of our sunrise. So we've still got... hi, Tez from Sweden. Good morning from Sanibel down in Southwest Florida. So here's the start of sunrise. So here we go. I'm going to show you how dark it is on the beach here. So I have our trusty flashlight, and you can see all of this good stuff here. And don't worry, I'm going to get you guys nice and low here. So here we have a little crabber. Unfortunately, a lot of these things are no longer alive. Some of them are and some of them aren't. So some of you guys ask why the beach is like this. It's not always like this. Hold on a second. Let me get organized with my shell bag. Gotta always have a shell bag with you guys just in case. So the beach is not always like this. It always depends on the storm. So in the winter time, when we have cold fronts come through and the storms come in, it really churns up the water and it brings in all of the sea life and the shells. So you guys will see some of these, like this conch right here is empty. Okay, so that would be a keeper. But this one right here, this tulip, if you can see that little guy, this one's alive. Do you see him move? So he's alive. So he is gonna stay right where he is. So you guys will be able to see a lot of living sea life. So we're gonna take a little step down. So here we've got a scallop, and this scallop's alive. So if I stuck my finger in there, I'd surely get it stuck. So let me see if I can hold my flashlight. There we go. And if you can see his little eyes, oh, there he's closing. Did you see him close? You can see they have a little row of eyes. I'm trying to hold it still so you guys can see the little row of eyes. There he's opening up for you. So you can see his little eyeballs. Hello, good morning, little scallop. Can you guys see his little row of eyes? I'm trying to get close without losing my finger. Let's see if he'll... Oh, and then he closes. So yeah, some of this stuff is very much still alive, so no worries for those of you that are throwing sad faces. And so here, if you guys can see, a lot of these little clams are also alive. You'll see them kind of spitting up water as they close. And don't worry, as it gets lighter, you guys will get a much better view. Here's a little crabber, a little crab moving in the conch. Let me see if I can get you guys a better view of him. Oh, he's turning this way. Where's he going? Oh, I scared him. And here's a little crab in a bubble shell. See if you can see him moving around. Let's see what else we've got. And for all of you shell seekers out there, hello to my Sanibel shell seeker group. Here's a nice murex, beautiful. Here's another conch, lots of conchs. They're all conked out. LOL. Hashtag funny. I gotta be funny, right? Here's another little crab taking a cruise. Let's see if I can get a up close to him. Hey, buddy. And you've got some cockles buried in the sand. What's this over here? Here's a nice tulip. Nice tulip here. So there's literally shells everywhere, and some of them are alive and some of them are not. So you guys can see, I mean, there's just shells. There's some shellers out here. Let me get a little sunset up, or a sunset, sunrise update. So there's your sunrise update. I will continue to update you on sunrise. Back to shelling. Here's another little scallop. Ooh, this will be a good eyeball view for you guys. There you get a good view of the eyes of the scallop. They have eyes just like us. That's why I cannot eat scallops. They're just so cute. There's a little crab sitting right next to him. Let's see what else we got, guys. Oh, here's something fun. You guys see this hole? Anybody know what this hole is? Any guesses what this little thing is right here, covered in sand? Any guesses? No guesses? That one, a flashlight in my mouth. That was a siphon and he was breathing. So this cockle was breathing. Let's see if he'll open up. Come say hello. You do not want to get your finger stuck in a cockle, you guys. That would be a definite not to do on the not to do list. Can you guys see him opening up? Come on, come say hi. Yes, yeah, so he's very much alive. Can you guys see that?
Which one are you looking at?
Oh, you're looking at a live cockle. You see him? Yeah. All right, so we're going to put him back and watch my fingers. Stick him back in the way he was so he can go back. Lots of scallops. Lots of scallops, lots of shells. Let's see what else I can find you guys that's fun. Here's a nice, oh, here's a nice murex right here. Let's see. Oh, here's another little. Okay, a lot of stuff's alive. Oh, here's a pretty true tulip. You guys see that? Yeah. All right, I don't know if you saw that, the little crab ran in there. Did you see that? So we're gonna leave that be. A little crab was in there. So it is illegal to take live shells. Here's a big stone crab for those of you stone crab fans who love stone crab legs. There's a big one. For those of you who don't know, it is illegal to take live shells. And so when you're shelling, it's really important that you double and triple check, because a lot of times you won't notice. You won't notice that there's a little crab in there. Like here, do you see the little tiny crab in this? Moving around. Oh, look what husband has, you guys. Look what husband brought over. Do you guys see a starfish? Here, I'll hold him in my hand and then we'll put him back in the water. Aww. How cute. All right, we'll put him back in the water. Can you guys see him? He is so cute, isn't he? Look at him moving. You guys can see him. They move pretty quickly, believe it or not. People think starfish and sand dollars are slow, but they can move when they want to move. You guys can see him go on a little cruise. Oh, maybe not. Now he's gonna stay still. Oh, they're pretty active. I don't think they like the light. Okay, so here's your little starfish, but you guys can see him. Okay, let's come back over this way. Lots of shells. Lots of shellers picking through them. You can see it's getting lighter. Sunrise check. Hi, Marlena. Good morning. Thank you for joining. Oh, my goodness. It is a little chilly this morning. Everybody's kind of bundled up. It's cold for Southwest Florida. It's probably really nice and warm for the rest of the world. But for here, it's cold. We're in jackets. It is cold. So there's just so many shells. And there are some that are empty, but you really just have to go through and look really closely. Here's a sea urchin for those of you who've never seen a sea urchin before. So here's a little spiny sea urchin. I'll flip it over so you can see the bottom. So at the bottom, that's where his little mouth is. That's where he eats. And you can kind of, I can't tell if this one's alive, but you would normally see, oh, it is alive. You guys should be able to, here, I'll try to hold this still. And you guys can see his little spines moving, maybe. You should be able to see his little spines moving. Can you see them moving? A little bit. Can you see the spines move? So he is alive. We'll give him a little toss back over here into the water. And here's a really pretty piece of sea sponge. That's kind of cool. Oh, and here's another sea urchin. So this is kind of one with short spines. And this is a longer spiny sea urchin. Do you see the difference in the spine length? So they're both sea urchins. I kind of put them together so you guys can see the difference. There we go. Both sea urchins. Just two different spine lengths, two different species of sea urchins. Look close, you'll be able to see their spines kind of moving very slowly. Oh, and here, somebody's trying to move over here. Let's see if I can catch some action for you of him moving around. He was, maybe if I take the light back a little bit. Maybe not. Move again, buddy. He was taking his little siphon trying to get out of there. Trying to be patient to see if he's gonna try to move again. This is why I could never be a photographer, like a professional photographer, because they sit there like all day being patient, waiting for like the perfect shot, and I'm just so not that patient. Okay, I'm moving on, guys. Okay, let's see what kind of shells we have over here. There's a little true tulip. See him hiding right there? It looks like somebody's living in there. And here's somebody climbing and crawling. Conchs, scallops, a little crab in a bubble shell. Here's an animal coming out of a murex. Hopefully my signal is holding strong for you guys. Oh, here's another pretty tulip that's alive. See this one? Got some little hitchhikers hanging on. Very pretty tulip though. So lots of shells. Oh, hold on, sunset check, or sunrise check. See, I always want to say sunset. I don't know why that rolls off my tongue easier, but it is sunrise. And it's getting lighter. Okay, I'm gonna turn off my flashlight now, which is good, because then I'll have an extra hand to show you guys some more stuff. All right, let's see. Here's a nice big bivalve. Look how pretty that one is. See, this is why you keep a shell bag with you. This is why. Keep a shell bag. Shell bag. And it's nice to have one that you can rinse your shells out and check them again before you take them home. Because you want to make sure that you don't have any hitchhikers in there. You don't want to get home and find out that you've got a little traveler with you. I think they're so funny. Do you guys remember earlier when I showed you the hole in the cockle that was taking a little breather? Do you guys remember that? Well, here's one again. You can see the hole before it was covered in sand, and now you can kind of see the hole. Oh, he's gonna close up. You see that? So he is alive. And it's funny because if you stand here, I don't know if you'll be able to see it on the camera. But if you stand here, you'll just see things like moving. You'll see all the little clams closing at the top there. You'll see, and you'll hear. Can you guys see up here at the top? That one trying to flip over. That you'll hear them like clanking together and closing and snapping shut. It's kind of funny. Can you see the one at the top up here? He's kind of funny. See if I can get close. It's kind of like Under the Sea in The Little Mermaid, and you have all the clams like opening and closing really quickly. There's just so much movement going on everywhere. Here comes husband with a starfish. So if you guys haven't seen a big starfish before, here is one, and underneath, so here's the little mouth. This is how they eat, right in the center. And then here you can see their little legs. So these are the legs. These are the legs. These are the big legs. But they have little feet underneath. And those little feet are what allows them to move. Can you guys see the little feet moving on the starfish? Can you guys see his little feet? So if you flip him over into the water, so he's got, how many legs does he have? 3, 8 legs? 9 legs. But then he's got little feet on the bottom of all those legs. It's a good size too. Big starfish. And you guys can see like all this stuff right here that I'm looking at, that I'm taking you guys on this tour. This is how far away it is from the water. Like, it's low tide right now, and you can see how far away it is from, like, this is how high the tide got. So don't worry about all this stuff. This is how high the tide gets, and this will all be back underwater. Oh, check this out, guys. Look over here. You guys will love this. All you giant shell lovers. Anybody like these? Anybody a fan? Who's a fan? Come on, give me some thumbs up. All right, so this is your giant horse conch. And it is alive. Lots of these are alive this time of year. It was actually crushing a poor little sand dollar. I think it broke it. It was like crushing it underneath. So this is a giant horse conch, and it is ginormous. It is huge. Can you guys see that? And this is the animal inside. So to give you guys an idea, and it is alive, people think that you can pull an animal out. Like, it doesn't matter. I could sit here and pull this all day. You are never gonna pull this out. So for people that think that you can just take a conch, any conch, and pull the animal out, it ain't gonna happen. It ain't gonna happen. You cannot. This is all a muscle. Okay, the animal. You cannot sit here and pull this out. It will not ever come out. People that eat them will traditionally boil them in hot water. I know, that's just terrible. I don't eat seafood, so just tell you that right now. But you cannot pull this out. This will not come out. So don't worry about if you think people pull them out, because they cannot. But this is alive. And you can see there's little hitchhiker crabs that live in here too. You can see little crabs. And then there's also, here's another little crab. And there's barnacles, and there's all little clams that live on here. So this is kind of like a whole complex for living things. But how cool and how big. This thing is heavy, guys. I'd say this is like at least maybe 10 pounds, 8 or 10 pounds. I can't even get my camera back far enough to show you. Absolutely ginormous. But yeah, we'll put this one back. Whew. And then you've got over here, tulips. We love the tulips. And then we've got another cockle that's alive. And you can see in here that they're kind of digging into the sand. So you can see the animal kind of coming out of them here. Let's take you guys for a walk so you guys can see the beach. Here's another big, oh, here's a little olive. You guys want to see olive tracks? So this is an olive track. This is what it looks like. So they do make tracks in the sand. Thank you, Janice. It's so nice to be back. So nice to be back. And so here's the olive. And it is alive, and I'll take it out to show you guys what it looks like. It's a beautiful little olive. So here's the olive. You guys have seen olives before, I'm sure. And then this is the little animal inside. And that's what it looks like. And it is really slimy. Like, olive animals are super slimy. And when they come all the way out, they can kind of all the way consume their shell. And they leave like this like super slimy film on your hands. But they're pretty cool. So we'll leave him. We'll get him back where he belongs. And here's another horse conch for you guys. A much smaller one than we just saw. But I want you guys to know that these horse conchs, these big conchs, they are home to so many different creatures. So even if this conch was empty, I would feel really bad taking it because it's still technically alive. So it's got barnacles living on it. It's got other shells living on it. It's got these slippers or Indian boats living on it. Do you see all these little baby slippers or baby Indian boats living on it? You've got big ones and then you've got small ones. So these are all shells living on the shell, which is kind of cool to see. So this is a much smaller one. You can see I can put my whole hand on it. And it's kind of buried itself in the sand. I'll flip it over so you can see the animal. So this is the animal that lives inside. See how it's nice and bright orange? And then you'll see the operculum, which is the trap door, which is right here. It's kind of sandy. But this is what closes up and protects the animal from being eaten. So this is the actual animal itself, the orange part right here. And then you can see when it closes itself, this part, which is covered in sand. Let me see if I can get some of the sand off. This part right here is like the trap door. So that closes flat and protects it. And this is a really pretty, really pretty adult horse conch. Very cool. So we're just gonna flip him back down, let him go back to burying himself in the sand. Come check out some tracks over here. This is a live sand dollar. So it is brown and it is burying itself in the sand too. And when you flip a sand dollar over, you'll be able to see its little feet move. I don't know if you guys will be able to see his little feet moving. I don't think he's wet enough. But you guys can probably see his little feet on the bottom. They look like hair. And we'll put him down. And then over here, if you can see these tracks, and if you follow them closely, they will lead you to a starfish. Hi, Erin. Good morning. Oh, I didn't know you were in Cape Coral. You could have joined me this morning. So here's your starfish and your starfish tracks. We've got all kinds of little things out here. I'm not even sure what this little creature is. And we've got little shark eye with a little crab. So it's just really fun to walk around at low tide and see the different creatures. And starfish. Ooh, that's a pretty one. And see his little tracks. So his tracks start over here. Follow them. He is headed in that direction. And let's do a quick sunrise check. So the sun is coming up over Fort Myers. Naples Marco is down there. Fort Myers Beach is over here. And here's coming up your sunrise on Sanibel. Here's your lighthouse, Lighthouse Point. And this is your low tide. See what this is here. Oh, look at this, you guys. Look how pretty. Oh, this is what kills you as a sheller. I'll tell you what. This is what kills you as a sheller. Look at that. Look how pretty and perfect and beautiful and alive. See the animal? So that's the animal part right here. And this is the trap door or the operculum. And this is a beautiful true tulip, like insanely beautiful true tulip. Look how big and beautiful and perfect. And all of you that are shellers should just be drooling, because I'm drooling a little bit on my phone right now. This is like beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. That's what kills you as a shower when you find something like that and you flip it over and it's occupied. Ugh. But at the same time, it's nice to know that they're out here breeding and reproducing so we can continue finding fun shells. Here's a little crab for you guys. Huh? Oh, thanks. Yeah, thank you. Here's a little crab for you guys. All right, we just were notified that there's something cool over this direction, so that's where I'm taking them. There's another big horse conch, guys. See this one? And it is alive. And right next to it here, right here. Let's see if I can dig it up. Oh, I think it's cracked. Anyway, this is what a sea urchin looks like without the spines. So this is dead and is already cleaned out, but this is what it looks like without the spines on it. For those of you who have never seen that before. And here, I might have to set you guys down. Let me see if I can do this with one hand. Here we have, hold on, I'm trying to roll up the yoga pants. Here we have a horseshoe crab. I don't know if it's alive or not. Let's see if I can get him to swim. You guys see the horseshoe crab? You guys see him? Mr. Horseshoe Crab. And hold on, we gotta do a sunrise check, guys, because it is coming up. Here you go. I don't want you guys to miss the beautiful sunrise. I'll let you enjoy this for a second. So we are, if you're just joining me now, we are at low tide on Sanibel, which is southwest Florida. And it is right by Fort Myers, north of Naples, on the west coast. And it is really chilly here this morning for Florida. So we are in the 60s, which I know that you guys are like, 60s, but let me tell you something. I live in Maryland, the other half of my life, and 60s in Maryland is like teacher weather, and 60s in Florida is like coat weather. So it is very breezy and chilly, and the sunrises are just absolutely beautiful here. Little seagull, kind of cute. They're just beautiful here, and we're at low tide, so you can see that there's the low tide line. And then this is the high tide line all the way up here, and you can see all the shellers going through. There's lots of shells, lots of big conchs that are alive. We love the big horse conchs. They're so cool. And hopefully you guys are enjoying this, because it is really fun. It is really fun to see. If you guys ever get the chance to visit Sanibel, I highly recommend it. Here's a stone crab for those of you who love stone crabs, and he is alive, so I have to watch my toes. He is very much alive. Very alive and very angry stone crab. Hey, buddy. Oh, and the water is chilly. Chilly, chilly, chilly. And there are just these horse carts everywhere, guys. Look at these. There's another little olive. Little olive here. You're welcome, Peter. I'm glad you're enjoying this. I'm glad you are enjoying this. This is really, I mean, I've seen this before, and it's still exciting every time I see this. It never gets old. It never gets old seeing a giant living horse conch. It's always amazing to see them and to be able to share it and show people and educate people, especially those people who have never seen it before. So yesterday I posted a photo in a group of a conch that looked just like this. And everybody thought that like I pulled the animal out and killed it, and I couldn't believe that anybody would think I would do that. But this, you can see here the little tracks of where it was digging in the sand. And this animal is very much alive. If I tickle it here, you can see it's contracting into its shell. It's going right back in. I want to be careful because if it goes in real quick, it'll take my finger with it. But, and you can see the operculum here, which is the trap door. And this shell is very, very much alive. It is very, very heavy. So if you want to do some bicep curls with this bad boy, you'll get a workout. But it is, like I said, and I'll say this again, you cannot, if you took this and you tried to pull this out, you will not pull it out. I don't care how strong you are. You will not be able to pull this out of the shell. It will not ever come out. So this animal is very much alive. And we're just gonna flip them over. Can you guys see the little hitchhiker crabs on there hanging out? So all of these shells are alive. Here's another one over here. I mean, they're everywhere, but they're alive. And they're just burying themselves in the sand, just waiting for high tide to come back. So no worries about people here. You know, taking live shells. People are very, very mindful of checking and making sure that anything that they take is vacant and unoccupied. Here's another horseshoe crab and a starfish.
Every time I pick up a purple one, it's a really
one. And here's some starfish tracks again, leading to a starfish and another sand dollar buried in the sand. Let me see if I can show you guys this one. Let's see if I can show you guys. Patty, I'm down on Sanibel Island in Florida, Southwest Florida. All right, so here's your sand dollar. All cleaned off. So this is what they look like when they're alive. They're brown. And when you flip them over, you guys will see the little legs and the little feet. And if you look really close, if I can get the angle good, you can see them moving. We'll see if you guys will be able to see them move. But those are the little hairs or the little feet. I'm like shaking you guys because I'm like so cold. Isn't that terrible? So that's your sand dollar. We'll actually put him in the water so he can hang out here. So that's your live sand dollar. And let's see, here's another cockle, guys, for those of you who missed it earlier. So just looks like a glob of sand, and you can see the little hole where it's breathing through.
It's alive. There's something in there.
And if we uncover it, you can watch the hole. It's closing up the hole. But if we take this up, thank you. You guys can see that it's alive. And this is what the shell looks like. So we'll put him back and look what we have here. Look how pretty this is. This is a shark eye or a cat's eye. And we've got somebody inside. We got a little crab in there. You guys see the little crab? I don't know if he wants to come out and say hello, but we'll put him right here by the water. But what a pretty shell. Look how pretty his shell is. Super pretty.
Oh yeah.
And some more sand dollars here. You can tell by the outline. And the birds are having a field day out here, as you can imagine. And there is your beautiful sunrise. It is up. It is up and it is bright. Lots of people. Lots of shellers. Not as many as I was expecting, but lots of shellers. So this is it, guys. This is Sanibel low tide. And I'll take you guys back down here for one more quick. Oh, look how cute this is. This is a little teeny sea urchin. So this is what they look like when they don't have spines. So when they die and the spines fall off, this is what they look like. Little spineless sea urchin. No, Patty, it's not always like this. There's always usually really great shells and stuff on Sanibel, but in the winter time especially, when the waters are cooler and we get cold fronts that come through and storms, it brings in all of this sea life. So a cold front came through last week. It really churns everything up out in the Gulf. And that's when you get all of this stuff that gets washed in. So this time last year, we had the same thing. We had a ton of sea urchins and starfish and sea life washed up on the beaches. So we definitely don't get this all the time. But you guys will see, like, if I stand up, can you guys see all the little tracks of all the little animals? So for example, like this little guy right here, can you see his little track? It's like little artwork. Ooh, little artwork of all the little squiggles of all the little shells. So I'm gonna walk down by the water. Here's another giant horsey. Giant horsey, I love them. We gotta love them, guys, we have to. It's just like a law that if you love shells, muscles, oh my gosh, it's so heavy. You gotta love the giant horses. You gotta love them. It's like, it's just such a thrill to see them. So here we are, down by the water. It's nice and calm. I'm gonna rinse my hand off. Oh, the water's actually not too chilly. It's just the air temperature. It's really cool. Here's another horse conch over here in the water. My gosh, you guys, look at this one. And these horse conchs, you guys, like, no joke, are like so heavy. Look how big this horse conch is. Like, I can't even, like, hold on a second. I gotta flip you around for a minute because I can't hold it that far out. But look how big. I can't even get it in, like, the whole camera. It's huge. This thing's, like, ginormous. It's absolutely huge. This is the thrill, guys, seeing these. I mean, it's really fun finding them empty because you get to take them home, but finding them alive is just amazing, absolutely amazing. Here, we'll have husband hold it so you can get a really good view of how big this thing is. Hold on. Hold this for a second. Here. So here.
What's your favorite?
So that's how big it is. Can you guys see that? Smile, honey. He loves being live. Can you guys see that? How heavy do you think that is?
7 pounds.
Seven? I said 8 to 10.
Yeah.
I think only seven.
No.
I'd say like 10.
It's got some weight to it.
Patty says hi.
Hi, Patty. I curl 80 pounds,
put
so
it
it's just hard for me to tell.
Put it up by your head. It is. No, hold it up like this. It is bigger than his head. It's ginormous. The thing's huge.
You said I had a big head.
You do have a big head. We'll go put it back in the water. Yes, these conchs are huge, you guys. Ugh, they are huge. Yes, they're absolutely huge, but they're so fun to find. And they're all over the beach. So let's see what we've got. I'm gonna take you guys back up here. So here's your sunrise. I keep showing you the sunrise. I don't know, I love it. And so here's the water. So this is your low tide. And then we're gonna walk back up to the high tide line. So if you guys missed me earlier, you guys will get to see what I was showing earlier again. Because it was pretty, there's some pretty fun things. And plus I don't have my flashlight in my hand. Oh, so here's a little conch trying to flip himself over. So this is another reason I told you guys earlier I can't eat scallops because they have eyes and they're cute. So can you guys see his little eyes? Like, they have eyes. Can you guys see his eyes? He's looking right at you. Like, literally right at you. This is why I can't have, like, conch fritters. No more conch fritters for me. Can you guys see his eyes? Yeah, conchs are adorable. No more eating conchs. Can't do it. All right, so we've got, what have we got? We've got starfish, lots of starfish. Oh, I wonder if this is, oh yeah, it's cracked. I'm trying to find you guys one that's not broken. Here's a really pretty lace murex with a little crab in it. Really pretty shell with a little crab living inside. So here is kind of the start of where everybody's sifting through things. And you guys will see that there's big shells, big whelks. Look how pretty that whelk is. Beautiful whelk. The animal inside. And this is where everybody's going through stuff. So I'm gonna give you guys one more little tour before I wrap this up. So you guys can see. It's a really pretty scallop. Kara, some of them do. You can see that there's some birds around that are eating them. Some of them do, but a lot of them are just hanging out until high tide. The high tide will come back in. And here's the calico crab, guys. They're really pretty. But yeah, Kara, some of them are just going to bury themselves in the sand. And when the high tide comes back in, they'll be fine. Oh, nobody's home. See, this is why you keep your shell bag, guys. Keep the shell bag with you. Pretty tulip. We'll rinse it off. Look here. Yep. See the animal, you guys. So yeah, so many of these things are alive, and it's kind of nice to see. I mean, we love collecting shells, but it's really nice to see them in a live state too. Here's one. Here's a keeper. Paper figs and parawhelks. I love them. They're so hard to find because they're so fragile. We usually find them broken, but it's nice to find them in one piece. So what do you guys think? Pretty cool, huh? So if you ever get a chance to come to Sanibel, come in the winter, right after a cold front, and this might be the site you get to see. Yes, we are right by the lighthouse. Here's the lighthouse. Eric, right here. Can you see it? Right there is the lighthouse. So we are not far. We are not far.
No, we're not
far. Hey. Look who's here, guys. Look who's here. Hey, hey, it's my shell sibling, Michael G.
Morning, everybody.
Hey.
Great day at the lighthouse.
Good to see you.
You too. Wow. Live broadcast, people.
It is live from the lighthouse. Yes, live
lots
from the lighthouse.
Of shells.
All right, guys, I'm going to wrap this up here. Thank you so much for joining me. And
bye.
And I will see you guys again soon. If you have questions, comment below and I'll be happy to answer them. Even if you missed me live, I will go back through and answer any questions that you guys have. I hope you enjoyed that and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.